But the first one I want to talk about is pretty straightforward, right? It's the life jacket, right? Life jackets are probably the most important thing. Like our kids are going to be jumping into unknown waters. And the number one risk is that of falling into the sea, being trapped by the water. And this relates to curriculum in education. The curriculum we have here in Alberta was made in the 1980s and the 1970s. So you can imagine we didn't have mobile phones in students' hands. We didn't have one half of Gen Z workers freelancing on AI platforms. So the kinds of life jackets that people had back then are very different than the life jackets we have today. And that's what we have with our curriculum, is something that prepares them for the future. And so what we really need is a new type of life jacket, one that's going to give them the skills that's going to protect them, keep them safe, even into the future. And so these types of skills, especially with the life jackets that we have today, are going to be very important. We need to think very carefully about the curriculum, about what we teach them. And this is something that I've noticed as well. There are systems out there. You can go to, like, for example, Code Ninjas in Calgary, and you can learn about coding. They have an interesting system, like a belt system for learning different levels of coding. However, there is no discussion around artificial intelligence. And to me, this is missing the point of talking about digital citizenship. Because as a digital citizen, we have to recognize that there are two new things that are different. The first is, as a digital citizen, your knowing code is like knowing the law online. And the second is knowing your data, protecting your data, and deciding where your data will go is your vote online. So if you know that coding is the new law and data is the new vote, you're going to be much more prepared for the future. You're going to have a modern life jacket that has the headrest that you can lean back on, allows you to breathe in any type of condition. And that's kind of my goal with artificial intelligence. Like when I talk about it, this is what AI means to me, is it's about teaching our kids that data and coding, those two go together. We need to talk about not just one, we need to talk about both at the same time. And the second part to that is that we also need to understand that we need to change our curriculum. We need to be preparing our kids to thrive in the future. And so that's something that I'm really pumped about as well to talk about. Now, when it comes to the first steps, what are the first steps that you need even before you get onto the water? It was this. It was practicing going into the water, right? It's practicing going into the water. You've got to raise your knees. You got to raise your knees up to make sure that you're still able to float and that you can still get on your back. If you're on the front, can you move onto your back? That's a big part of safety. And so that's what we had to do before we even got onto the water. The other is, and I don't know if you can see it here. You see that? So that is a pleasure craft operator's license. So you need to know a little bit about the safety and the rules of the road today, like safety at sea today. And so you cannot go out boating without one of these in Canada. And so for me, this also relates to having a pleasure craft operator's license is about knowing the rules in education, like understanding how education works and understanding what are some of the hazards that you have to deal with. And that's why I think for anybody who is thinking about the upcoming trustee election in Calgary for wards 1, 2 and Cochrane, I think it's really important to consider what is their experience. What is their experience specifically working in like the education, the administration side? So not just as a student, but as like somebody who is helping with administration during the COVID-19 period, because things are very different during COVID-19. I think we need to very carefully consider what are the rules? The rules have changed. The things that we have to worry about, we never had to consider before. These are brand new waters that we are entering. What is the experience? How is that experience working during this time, working for you? And that's why having that experience, that pleasure craft operator's license, is so important. So, I don't know if you can see that. I have a compartment. Of course, I have a compartment for this. And in it, you can see a flashlight and extra batteries, because you never know, like your flashlight might be out of batteries. And so having a basic flashlight, one that, you know, it's a little bit, you can see it a little bit, you know, if I point it direct, is important, because sometimes the light not only shows us where we are headed in the dark, like it shows our direction, but it can also be a beacon for others. So what this means is that our light can be something that can guide other districts and can guide other regions. So we have to consider our decisions carefully. We need to make sure that, yeah, we're pointing in the right direction. We're pointing in a way that is leading other people, not just, oh, we're just reacting or we're trying to like copy somebody. It's like, no, we don't need to copy other people. We need to be the ones pointing the light in a particular direction and leading. And to me, this is very important. This notion of like the light is kind of what is guiding people, is that we have an opportunity to not only be followers, but really to be leaders in this space. And I've seen this. I've seen this in Calgary Catholic. And I believe that we have that opportunity, especially when it comes to leading the way for a curriculum that is there to protect kids, something that is going to give them the skills, the 21st century skills that will not be replaced by automation, outsourcing, and digitization. This, we can be the ones leading the way. That is the opportunity that is ahead of us. And it's something that I am very excited about, because, you know, this is it. Like, this is one of the reasons I've worked in education for over education and technology for over 15 years. And I've come to the realization that education, like it or not, is always going to be connected to politics. That's not going to change, right? In 20 years, in 50 years, since the dawn, since the creation of education, education has always been connected to political goals. And so part of our goal here is you've got to make whatever you point to align with those political goals. And being a trustee is another way of understanding those political goals so that it's beneficial for all parties. And so that is something that I feel is very important. We can lead the way, and we should lead the way. But I think the important thing is, how are you leading? What guidance are you providing? And it is not good enough to just say, oh, okay, well, you know, we're just going to like follow what other school districts do. In Calgary, I feel that that's a very narrow perspective. There are school districts all over the world. In California, there are school districts in Dubai. Like, look at what is happening in the best schools in New York or in other places in the world. Find out what practices make sense for us in Calgary. Not only the options that are available right inside of like other districts in Calgary. I think that there's good opportunities for us to take a leadership role here. What I can tell you is that AI is not a part of the Alberta curriculum at this time. And I can also tell you that it's not even a part of like private training that you can get. They don't even teach those. They teach coding and they don't teach AI. But if you look at places in the world, like in New York, or if you look at places like Dubai, they are actively looking at how can we teach AI to our kids right now so that they are ready for working when their boss might be an AI. They're taking it very, very seriously. And in the same way, in education, if you went to China, for example, for education, they are teaching AI in kindergarten. right? In kindergarten, there's already textbooks for artificial intelligence. And all the way through grade 12, they want to become a world leader in that. So you imagine our child growing up here in Calgary, trying to compete with somebody who's been learning this since kindergarten. What chances do we have to compete? How are they going to thrive? These are the real things that I'm very concerned about. And it's one of the reasons why I thought this is a good reason to run for Catholic school trustee. And so this is the light guiding the path. Okay, so it's another thing that I'm really passionate about. The other one that I want to talk about now is sunblock. Okay, sunblock. And for those of you who haven't seen it, like, you can get sometimes like a tent or an awning that will cover over the top of an inflatable boat. So like, this is a Yuzhang travel product, you know, just some kind of, it's basically like a little tent that goes on top that blocks the sun. Or you have like the spray on like sunblocks that are typically used. So with these sunblocks or these sunshades, really dehydration and not getting enough water can be a nuisance at best, and it can be a serious risk at worst. And here I'm talking about dehydration and like too much sun for your operators. And so I think that in addition to our students, it's like, what care do we have for our teachers? You know, how are we ensuring that educators are getting the kinds of breaks that they need, the times in the shade away from the sun? They are so stressed, and our children cannot be good if our teachers are not good. And so I firmly believe, like, yes, we at Isidore, one of our priorities was making sure that staff wellness was our priority. And I think that, you know, that's a really strong approach. And I think it's not considered often enough. Like, they do need a break. Teachers do need a break. We need to recognize the kind of hard work that they've done. They have some of the most creative ideas, but they need an environment where that creativity is encouraged. They need a safe place, a place with shelter, right? Where they're not constantly under fire, that is going to allow them to flourish, to have that flexibility. And it's actually one of the things that I really noticed about Calgary Catholic, because I've been to both school systems. I grew up myself in the CBE system, and my kids are through the CSSD system. And during my time, and just to give you a little bit of background, having spent 15 years in education and technology, I used to work for Smart Technologies, and now I work with different companies in consulting as well, was that choice, freedom of choice. The more you have voice and choice, the more flexibility, the more creative they can be, the better the outcomes. And that's why I'm a huge advocate for it. It's you. It's parents who know best. So the more we can create a safe environment, a sheltered environment for those types of ideas, the better outcomes we're going to have for our kids. And the happier they're going to be. They're not going to be like, oh, I'm constantly under the sun, under fire. Shelter, right? We need that. The next one that you need for safety before you even get on the boat. What's this? What is this? This is a paddle, right? Yes. Okay. So you need, sometimes we need to be very hands-on, okay? And sometimes we need some manual efforts in order to get things done. And this is why action is so important for me. I don't want to just talk about education and talk about, oh, this is like, these are good things for our kids. And, you know, this is how I'm going to help our kids thrive. Like, I don't want to talk about it. I want to do it. I want to be a man of action. And to me, this has always been really important. So we didn't just talk about awareness, you know, of the First Nations communities. We talked about what action can we do today that is going to help Indigenous people right now, today. And I think that this kind of approach to action is a very positive one, because you get to see how their experience is a lived one, and our ability to help is tangible. It's real. It's something that we can do today. And so that's one of the reasons why I feel like sometimes you need a like something like this, like a paddle. You need to manually get in there. You really need to start moving. And so I don't want to just talk about the importance of these skills that will not be replaced by automation, outsourcing, and digitization. It's also one of the reasons why I'm working actively to try to create the curriculum that is going to help develop these 21st century skills. I'm working with some individuals, some educators in New York and in Dubai. And my goal, by working with them, is to combine their expertise in the social emotional foundation with their expertise in pedagogy. They do a lot of problem-based learning, to think about what are fun ways that we could teach AI and make it fun and give them the kinds of life lessons that are going to help them succeed now and in the future. And you'll see more of that from me. And that's really kind of my objective was, ever since having kids, it's really put a focus on the work that I do for education, that I'm doing this for a very strong reason. I work in education because when I was young, I was a really tough kid, right? I struggled a lot in school. And things were not easy for me, but I had great supports. And it's part of my way of, you know, paying it forward. All the things that I've received, all the advantages that I've been given, I am extremely thankful for. And I've always had parents that were very positive about everything. And they found, like, in all of the bad things that I did as a kid with undiagnosed attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, or ADHD, it was this realization that they always found the positive, and they always believed in me before I even believed in myself. And it required that type of belief in order for me to believe in myself. So they believed in me until I believed in myself. And that was something that I'm extremely thankful for. And that's one of the reasons why I say, it's like, let's put some effort in. Let's put the effort in. Let's make it happen, right? Let's put them. If it needs manual rowing, I'm going to do that. Right? I'm going to make that happen for you.